A few things come in mind when you think about minimalism, at least in regards to fashion. And those four things that I think is black, navy, white, and gray. Everyone knows that a minimalist wardrobe consists of common projects, Norse projects, and whatever projects you can fucking fit in from a Scandinavian designer. But I think we've gotten really sidetracked by the aesthetic of minimalism rather than the core value of it. What's up, guys? This is Kevin here from Fashion Forward Always. I'm talking about minimalism, at least in regards to fashion. So minimalist fashion, I guess. I think people approaching minimalism from a fashion standpoint, a lot of the times it's sort of flipped on its head. At least that's what I came to minimalism sort of for. And the more I looked into minimalism and the more that I focused on it, I realized that I was focusing on the incorrect stuff rather than the core value of it. I was focusing more on the material stuff rather than the actual core value, which is sort of in itself kind of ironic. So minimalism is about keeping only the items that truly bring you joy and that add value to your life, which is contradictory to the multitude of layouts that tell you that you need the Achilles low and that you should buy Acne Studios denim to fit in and all that jazz. You should buy those items if they truly do add value to your life rather than approaching it from only an aesthetic point of view. Because at that point, it really isn't minimalism. It's just wearing monochromatic colors. And the funny thing is that you can be a minimalist and still like color. So we all know that generic hashtag minimalism inspo, but a minimalist can essentially wear whatever the fuck they want, as long as it adds value and that it truly does have your own, or at least you see value within it. Minimalism is stripping away the excess and the fat of life and just sort of streamlining it. And whether or not that streamlining it can result in like a monochromatic wardrobe or whether or not you have a colorful wardrobe, as long as that stuff to you is essential, then that's minimalism. So for example, I love my Air Jordan Off-White 1 and I also love my Travis Scott Air Jordan 4s. Both of them do not fit within the traditional minimalist, I guess, wardrobe. For example, the Common Project would, or a Stan Smith would. But that doesn't mean I can't be a minimalist. If those things really do add value to my life, and that it isn't just taking up space for the sake of taking up space and making me feel better, then fuck it, it adds value. So I'm not bashing people completely for liking the minimalist-esque, I guess, aesthetic. But I think rather than focusing on purely the material goods and the products, I think we should really focus on the core subject of it and then expand outward and have it affect your fashion as well as lifestyle and as well as your habits. And there are plenty of businesses trying to take advantage of people, especially people who want to approach minimalism, but then they're like, this is the must-have for a minimalist, or this is, you know, a minimalist dream, or this is whatever a minimalist should have. No, that's not quite right, because essentially they're just saying, hey, you need this, which is exactly what you don't want in minimalism. You want to decide what you need, not somebody else. So I guess the main goal of this video is to show that there really isn't a strict guideline to being a minimalist, at least in terms of fashion and clothing, is that you can be a minimalist while wearing fucking purple, red, or turquoise, or any crazy colors. As long as it adds value and that it adds joy to your life, it should be fine. Then you are still a minimalist, just as long as you cut out the excess and cut out what you don't actually need and what actually doesn't bring you joy. You just cut that out, only have the things you love, you'll live a happier life and you won't fall for the pitfalls of a lot of, I guess, hype media and hype marketing. So this has been Kevin. Let me know what you guys think about this type of content. I'm not saying that I'm a perfect minimalist. I barely started this journey, but I just thought this was an interesting talking point, and I'd like to shed some light upon it. So yeah, thank you guys so much. Talk to you guys later. Peace.